guys, how's it going? And welcome back to a very windy episode. Today we're going to be talking about Mérida, the cultural capital of Latin America, or the Americas, or whatever. So I just finished an appointment right now. Just left the house. I had my camera with me. And, you know, as I was finishing up, I was having a conversation with my client. And we were just talking about the fact that, you know, about how Mérida is growing, you know, how it's grown so much in just the last, like, you know, not just the last, like, 20 years, but definitely in the last, like, several years. And the growth that this city still has yet to have. And, you know, we were talking about from different perspectives. You know, she, you know, is an American that lives out here. An American with Latin roots that has been living out here for over 20 years. It's a family member, friend of mine, you know. And I myself have only been here for, you know, about a year and a half now, give or take. And, you know, we were just talking about growth, you know, and like city growth and how cities grow. Not just this city, but others. We were talking about, I was telling her about my experience living in places, you know. First of all, she was from Miami, so she knew Miami back when it was nothing and saw a lot of the growth that came there. She also, you know, then I was telling her about, you know, my time in Seattle as to like how, you know, when I first got to Seattle, it was a very similar situation where it was a city that was only beginning to start growing. Again, for anyone out there from Seattle, they can acknowledge the fact that Seattle was a completely different city 10 years ago than it is today. And there's a lot of places like that. And, you know, then I, you know, we talked about the fact that, you know, when I was living in Los Angeles and other places like that, as to how they dealt with the growth and they dealt with situations. So, you know, we were having, one of the things that we were talking about was the bus route and the bus situation out here. Because it's funny, because when I made that bus video, talking about the bus situation out here, I thought I was going to get a lot of negative flack. I'm not even going to lie to you. I was already expecting a lot of locals or a lot of people to, you know, give me some sort of negative reaction to that video. And not really, you know, like it seems like I was pretty on point. And then even after I was talking to her, even though she was defending the bus system and then a little bit of the situation out here, you know, at the end of the day, when I was, you know, when we were talking, she did acknowledge that I was right. And she did acknowledge that this place is a mess. But she just gave me more insight as to why it's a mess. And, you know, that goes to like a little bit of the libertarian perspective out here, meaning that, you know, the reason that things are probably a little bit more of a mess than they should be is because of the fact that this place is pretty libertarian and the people run the show, not the government. But then what happens is that like when the people want to run the shows too much, then, you know, all of a sudden the government is like hands off because they know that there's nothing that they can do anyway. And then they just let the people fend for themselves. And eventually it just turns into a shit show. And therefore, you know, it just makes it even harder, you know, for any kind of change. And in fact, you know, by the time that the government change comes along, it's usually because the people have had enough. Let me see, I think I'm gonna cross here. Because the people have had enough. And as a result of that, you know what I mean, then they beg the government to change things. But regardless, you know, today's episode is really more about, well, I mean, it is about the growth of the city, you know. It's talking about that, even though I said it was, you know, about culture and art and stuff like that at the very beginning a few minutes ago. That is a very important topic and segue to what I'm talking about because, you know, there's a lot of awesome positive things that is that will allow this city to grow and to become a place that everybody wants to be. And one of the main things behind that is the fact that, you know, this is like, again, an art and cultural capital. It really is. And it's really, really windy. I hope that everything I'm saying will come through and it's not, you know, messed up by the wind. But, you know, like I was saying, it's like, you know, the fact that this city is so virgin in the sense of like it has no idea what a big city really, you know, goes through on a regular basis. You know, the fact that this place has been such a hidden gem for so long, and now all of a sudden we're at a moment in time in which, oh, okay, so this is what she was talking about here. She was, anyways, but we're now in a moment in time in which, you know, there's a lot of change happening all over the world. So, you know, this city is growing, not just only because it's growing and it's awesome out here, but because, you know, there's so many people from around the world that are looking for a new place to live, a better place to live. And, you know, this happens to be one of those places that's going to see the insane amount of growth that other cities had seen in the past, only because, you know, this place is just awesome to live in for a million reasons. So for example, one of the things that we were talking about is like this particular street right here, which is Street 47. As you guys can see, there's a lot of construction and building, and even all the way down this way. I've never really been down this street. I walk down the street sometimes, but not that much. And but one of the things he was saying is that, like, you know, all this is going to end up being closed off, this street. And there's already a lot of restaurants and a lot of really awesome places, you know, being, you know, put all around here. Hold on. You know, a lot of nice fancy restaurants, galleries, and stuff like that. You know, again, in Calle 60, you know, 60th Street, which is the street that I come down a lot. You know, there's a lot of that stuff as well. A lot of art, a lot of art galleries, a lot of restaurants, a lot of new things like that. They're doing the same thing here. In fact, that what they plan on doing is that they want to build like a Central Park type area more towards the end of that way. You know, where there's there used to be a big railroad station and all this other stuff. So, you know, she was telling me about all the things that they're, you know, more things that they're adding and implementing out here. I was letting her know how, you know, how some of these things are going to be good, some of them are going to be bad, you know, especially from a traffic perspective, a growth perspective. And it was just funny because we, you know, it was one of those things that I told her. I go, like, man, we could be talking about this topic here for hours, you know, for days, for, you know what I mean? This is like one of these subjects that we could definitely be talking about for a long time. And that's why as soon as I left and I had my camera with me, I told myself, you know what, let me start recording and continue talking about this subject, because I think that it's a very, very important topic. So, you know, one of the main topics that, you know, she was talking about and bringing up, you know, was the fact here, I'll show you, you know, was the fact that, you know, again, you see a lot of growth and a lot of building, a lot of everything. And, you know, how a lot of this stuff, you know, is really happening is basically that it's people like us that are coming here. You know, a lot of expats, a lot of people coming out from Europe or the United States or other parts of the world, and we're coming out here and we're the ones that are doing the building, because the people here themselves aren't necessarily doing that or in any need or want to do that. And on top of that, the speed that they work out here, you know, we've discussed a lot of these topics. Everything is beyond slow motion, and it can be a little frustrating, especially coming from, you know, especially as an American, you know, definitely for, especially as an American, because, you know, again, she's been living here 20 years. She's of Cuban background descent, but still, you know, she lived in Miami and you know, us Cubans and just like Americans, we have a lot of things in common in which, you know, time is money. And you know, it's like, you know, you could take it in many ways. You know, it's not just a simple capitalistic, you know, sense of like the time is money, but literally, you know, the fact that, you know, just how we, you know, live in the U.S. and in Cuba and shit like that, but mainly in the U.S., you know, with the whole capitalism aspect to things, it's just that's the way of life. You know what I mean? Like, it's just completely different culturally in so many aspects, so many, you know, different, yeah, aspects. Yeah, sorry, I had like a little bit of a brain fart there. But, all right, let me cross the street here. But, you know, that's like a, you know, again, a major component, you know, the fact that, like, you know, why there's such a big difference in culture out here as opposed to back in the U.S. is because out here, and especially here in this area, you know, things are, you know, very, 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 very laid back. And it's the reason being is because, you know, the even though this is Mexico, we, you know, it's all Mexican culture, you know, in this particular part of Mexico, things are just a little bit more different because there's more Mayan influence. The people out here don't consider themselves Mexican. The Mexicans don't consider them Mexican either. It's like Yucatecan, people from the Yucatan, people that are Mayan, you know, that whole thing. It's like a completely different mindset and everything. And now here, they're even more laid back than everywhere else. Everything here is, you know, like so laid back that it hinders growth, it hinders movement, it hinders so many things. And so, you know, when you come out here as a tourist, or you come out here, you know, just to live, or, you know, a lot of these other things, you know, it's very cool, it's very cute. It's one of those things that, you know, you actually, you know, enjoy. You know what I mean? Like, you know, you, it's like a, it's a different form of life. It's a different way to experience things. You know, it's like not that big of a hurry. Everything is more laid back. All these things, and it's great. It's great. You know what I mean? But when you're living out here, or if you're coming to do business out here, okay, then that's when things start getting frustrating as fuck, because you're just moving at a completely different speed. And even though there might be a lot of other people out here that might be moving at your speed or wanting to move at the speed that you move at, they can't keep up, because they just can't, because we come from a different, you know, we're just a different breed. You know, we're just, you know, way, you know, we just have a different way of doing things. And so when you as an expat or again, just, yeah, I mean, I don't want to say expat, I got to find another word. You know, when you as a extranjero, I mean, as a foreigner, there you go, that's the word, foreigner. When you as a foreigner, you know, you come out here, you know, that's one of the things that, you know, you can take full advantage of, is the fact that, you know, if you come from, especially from the U.S. or any country in which it's, you know, business, you know, go, 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 all of a sudden you come out here and, you know, you're a highly coveted commodity. You just are, because when all of a sudden you're moving at half speed, but you're still moving 10 times faster than the average person out here, that's a major advantage. And imagine if you're actually moving at full speed, then the advantage is even greater. And then if you're able to do things and you don't need to necessarily hire help, but when you're hiring, again, you're using the United States of America, the whole capitalism, you know, thing to its full force. Again, guys, you know, the sky's the limit out here. And if you have the right mindset coming out here, you can make not just make a lot of money, but make a lot of network. You could do a lot of networking. You could do a lot of things. And it comes in every aspect, guys. You know, it's not just like if you want to, you know, put a building, or if you want to, like, you know, have an Airbnb. It can be anything. You know, anyone out there that's an artist, anyone out there that's into technology, anyone out there that's pretty much into anything, because, you know, an entrepreneur, anything, because, you know, like, for example, look at the, right now we're about to pass some guy, you know, that's just selling stuff on the street, like you see this here all the time. But imagine that you come out here with real entrepreneurial spirit, like, you know, from the U.S., and you start putting up one of those. Well, I'm going to tell you straight up, if you know, you come from a real capitalistic nation, and you come out here and you put up, you know, like just a small little business, you know, within a month, you're going to have two. Within a few months, you'll have three, four. And by the end of the year, you're going to have a little bit of a fucking empire. And it's just the way it is. You know what I mean? It's just because of we come from a different source, you know, of, a different culture. I'm sorry. We just come from a completely different culture. And that's like an advantage that we have out here, because the people out here, they want our culture. They love our culture. You know, the way I see things happening, sorry about the music, guys, you know, but the way I see things is like basically the fact that, you know, Mexico and the area out here of, you know, this, especially this area of Mexico and Central America and just everything out here, you know, they are looking to become more Americanized, become more like the United States. And in the same turn, a little puberty thing there. Anyways, but with the same turn of the coin, you know, the United States and America itself is looking to be, you know, more integrated into like Latin America and Mexico. So, you know, what do I mean by all this? All right, let me see. I gotta cross the street. Should I wait? All right, let me see. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do here real quick. But anyways. You know, these are all like major advantages that we have out here. And this city is only beginning to grow. This city hasn't even really started in growth. You know, I know that the people that have been living here their whole lives, or have been living here for a long time, they actually get to see, you know, they actually get to, look at this. This is beautiful. Maybe let's see. I gotta, look at that. How sexy do I look, huh? This is gonna be for the thumbnail. But anyways. But yeah, so like I was saying. You know, the potential for growth here hasn't even been tapped yet. You know, this city has been growing for a long time now. You know, again, you ask like the typical person that lives out here, that is from out here, and they'll tell you straight up that I guess I was one of the first ones to try that thing, huh? This is a brand new thing. But anyways, there's a lot of, like, the growth has not even begun to start yet. And, you know, like, from my conversation today, I got to learn a lot. And, you know, I got to learn that there's a lot of people out here, more than what I originally thought, that are actually, that understand the actual significance of the growth that's happening out here. And that's the potential growth that's not just happening, but will happen, and so on and so forth. So, for example, even though there's plenty of people out here that just have no idea that, you know, I just started to think, I hope I didn't, that thing wasn't painted or something. I got fucking paint all over me. That would be fucking hilarious. Anyways, I'm always distracted by stuff. But yeah, anyway, so yeah, there's like a huge group of people, and it just keeps growing and growing and growing, you know, of people that are wanting to come out here. And they really understand the potential growth of all this stuff out here. So for example, like this hotel behind me is a boutique hotel. I walk by here all the time, and I recommend this place all the time because, again, you know, these places are few and far in between out here. But when you look at the scene of all these things around the world, you know, what we're seeing behind me is nothing new. It's like you see that everywhere. When I look across the street and like I look at that building that's been under construction for, I want to say, a year and a half now, and like it hasn't done anything, it's like I see like the potential of what that will be. I see that as that, you know what I mean? Like, literally, you know, eventually that will be that over there, which I know you can't see, but there's a huge tree in the way, but that right there has been under construction for the same amount of time, and that thing is going to end up being a major like a hotel, or who knows, you know what I mean? Like, for example, this is a really fancy hotel here. All right, this is where all like the baseball players and famous people like to stay at. It's not that, you know, it's not that crazy, you know what I mean? Like, you just walk a few like 15 minutes that way down Paseo Montejo, and I've shown you guys already the Marriott, Holiday Inn, and so on and so forth. And you know, like right there, that could be apartment buildings, that could be another hotel. Regardless, you know, everywhere we see, we're seeing galleries, we're seeing high-end stuff, we're seeing low-end stuff, we're seeing, you know, again, you know, what they're building in that street that I showed you on Street 47, you know, what they plan on doing there is, you know, again, even build more restaurants towards the end of the street. They want to do like a Central Park type thing. They want to open up even more museums. They want to open up even more, you know, culture and art centers, and so on and so forth. So it's like there's plenty of people out here, you know, or people that are coming out here that are realizing, you know, the potential of this place. And not only that, but like, you know, the fact that, yeah, hey guys, sorry about that. Again, the heat turned off the camera. You already know the drill. But anyways, as I was saying before I got rudely interrupted, you know, this place has yet to see its potential fully maximized. It's not even anywhere close to it. I can't wait to see this place in 10, 15 years. Literally, it's going to be amazing. It's going to be such a different city that people are not even going to recognize, you know, what this place is. Again, I can't wait to see what they build here. I can't wait to see what they finish building there, and so on and so forth. You know, if just the things that I've seen are any indication, it's going to be amazing. And so for anyone out there, you know, that's out there, you know, that moved out here like me, you know, just for a better life, you know, whether you just want to live your life or whether you're coming out here for business opportunity, for you know, for all kinds of things, you know, cultural, whatever, you know, this city has, you know, as soon as you get here, it's just going to keep going up and up and up, and it's just going to only get better and better with time. And you know, honestly, you know, this city is beyond amazing. Some people don't really welcome the growth, and I get that, but honestly, I welcome the growth, and I think a lot of people will eventually welcome and love the growth. And it's only gonna make this city better, just like for the most part, it always makes a lot of cities better. And especially in the case of this one, I think it's gonna be awesome. And for those out there that choose to take it upon themselves to help build this place, to help, you know, build this place, again, not just construction, but build this place, you know, with culture, with, you know, with art, you know, with all kinds of things, you know, with your experience, with your knowledge, with your own culture, with your own everything. All this stuff is just going to help make this place an even bigger melting pot than what it already is. And you know, to me right now, this is basically a European Mayan city with a little bit of Mexico sprinkled on top. Now imagine when this place really starts getting, you know, more diverse and more culturally open. It's going to be even more awesome than anything. I mean, look, again, my girlfriend, you might look at her and she might be like, oh, she looks like a Mayan girl. But if you really look at, if you really ask her background, you know, she has Korean in her, she has European, you know, she has so many things. And then like when it comes to like Mexican, it's like a tiny little bit. And, you know, if you ask a lot of people out here, you know, like the history out here and the stuff out here is not like the rest of Mexico. So, you know, I think I'm going to end it here because I think, you know, this thing's about to die again. And I think I've already talked about enough. And I think I've given you guys enough also to continue this conversation, because I would love to continue the conversation. I want you guys to ask me questions, you know, for us to really explore this topic even further, because I think that, you know, this is something that there's a lot of you guys out there that, you know, would like to know more of on. Because again, whether you're an artist that wants to just live out here, whether you're looking to retire, whether you're looking, you know, for this place as a business opportunity, you want to put a restaurant, a hotel, an art gallery, you know, it doesn't matter, car dealership, regardless. At the end of the day, you know, this is a place that is only going to see a lot of growth. There's a lot of places around the world that are in this particular predicament at the moment. And, you know, right now I'm covering what's going on here. And please, I want to hear from you guys, you know, what you thought about today's episode, what you guys think about this situation out here, and what you yourself, you know, what your plan is out here. You know what I mean? When you come, whether you're a tourist, whether you want to live out here, whether you want to do business, and all that stuff. All right, guys, that's it. I'm done here. I want to give a big shout out to all my patrons. I want to give a big shout out to every single one of my contributors out there. I want to give a big shout out to every single one of you supporters, all of you guys, all, whether you guys are, you know, sending me a few bucks, sending me Bitcoin, sending me Lambo food, buying t-shirts, you know, it doesn't matter, spreading my videos all over the place. You guys are awesome. I love you guys. You know, you guys are the best, and I wouldn't be able to do any of this stuff without you. And that's it. Don't forget to please like, please subscribe, please share, please hit that bell icon. And last but not least, don't forget to stay awesome. Enjoy life. Enjoy the rest of your day. It fucking cut off right at the end. Anyways, love you guys. Peace out. And have an amazing, amazing rest of your day. Bye. See you guys mañana. And now, the best part of my day, of my weekend. Hey! All right, guys. I got real important stuff I gotta do, so I'll see you guys later. Bye. Hey guys, guess what? Me and Lambo are still here. We haven't left yet. You know why we're here? Because I wanna tell you all about this new store that I just opened up. Yeah, that's right. It's our new sponsor as well. Let me tell you a little bit more about it. So, as you guys can see, this is the store. I just opened up the store, I don't know, about a week ago, and I'm gonna be selling all my merch and all of our stuff here, whether it's Lambo stickers, whether it's, you know, mugs, t-shirts, jackets, you name it. We got all kinds of stuff that you guys can buy and help support the show. Now you get to have your very own shirt or your very own Lambo sticker. And if you guys want any special requests on things for me to put in the store, then please, by all means, let me know, and we'll get our graphic artist, you know, on top of it. Yeah, that means you gotta work, Lambo. All right, guys, thank you so much. Love you guys, and I'll see you guys mañana.